Well, friends, with these two excellent lectures, of course, there's a point of view from head of a educational institution, and lots of thoughts in my mind, but I would start. IoT is a continuation of internet revolution. I don't know what is going to happen further. I can only tell you that from the educational point of view, he was talking about 5 trillion economy. We talk about the GDP and its relation to economy and other things. Why do we talk that? Because that's how society progresses. And one of the core factor of society to progress is education. Our job is to give you up-to-date education. That up-to-date education is what? That up-to-date education is things are changing. Nobody would have, when you join Polytechnic, probably you may not have heard what this IoT is going to be. When you are going to pass through Polytechnic now you may find there are opportunities in IoT which you would not have never thought when you wanted to go to Polytechnic. My point here is, the world is changing, continuously changing. Its requirements are changing. Its needs are changing. And there are solutions we have to give. He was talking about so many things, what we can do, from scalability to standardization to problems. So there is a scope. I'm not bothered about whether we are going to lose jobs. We are going to create huge jobs. Huge jobs, I'm telling you. Because for everything you need human agency. Without human agency, nothing is going to happen. But then what is the country? I'm more worried about India, and I'm more worried about you. What is the contribution of India to this technology? And not only this technology, for any technology, not even 1% India can boast, which is the second largest world population, and we don't have even 1% contribution to technology. Now that's my worry. And there I see a huge potentiality in IoT. As I told you, the internet revolution, somewhere 1992-94, it started. I can very proudly tell you, when it started, this was the only institution in Thorle Bajira. We had a conference on internet technology, and this campus was hired the first that they used to call it the internet cafe. It was costing 75,000 rupees, and there were only 2 computers we had here, and Polytechnic, and they helped us a lot. We started there then, in this campus. I'm happy today, IoT is again discussed here. See friends, unless and until you are connected, it's a communication. How are you going to remain communicated, you tell me? You are going to remain communicated by going to your libraries, because you are going to learn something basics in your classrooms. It's more a textbook education, which should expand now to a further step of IoT. But you have to go to libraries, and what do? Unless and until you are connected yourself, communicating yourself to research journals. Now the knowledge you are going to get of tomorrow is not within your textbooks. Is in this such conferences or in your journals. Now journals you get, databases you get in your library. I tell you, you have heard one journal called, which is a buzzword now, AI. It is artificial intelligence. Many people in 1980s and 85 never knew here, even technology people, there is something journal called AI. Why I'm telling you this? Exact year I may be wrong, we can find that out. But one of the paper in AI magazine, which was published from America, carried an article of Sanskrit language and its probable utility for machine language. You know, there's a natural language and there are machine languages, and they want to see that whether natural languages can be used for machine. It was difficult those days. And one paper appeared in AI journal. That paper never appeared in any humanity journals or any language journal or any other. It was in AI journal. My point here is that was an American. That was an American who was learning on languages. He learned that there is something, somebody called Panini, and that's absolutely in scientific method of putting language. There's a logic in that, 2 + 2 = 4. And that's why he thought that this can be useful for machine language. My point here is, friends, why not an Indian? Unfortunately, next 25 years, Indian use that paper for emotional purposes, not technological purposes. Nothing happened on technology fronts from Indian side again. Whatever has happened is from the American side, taking some clue from that paper. Second thing I can tell you in AI, I know that. Where have you learned that? This all you're talking is from human anatomy. Scientists were amused to see how we process. How we process our intelligence, how we think, how we take decisions. There are lots of inputs, they go to us and immediately we take a decision. Immediately. How do you do that? So neural networking was a buzzword those days. And how many papers, 0.001% Indians have not contributed to neural networks then? I'm talking about 25 years back. Everything they started learning from neural networks, how it functions here. And that they analyzed, the brain working, they wanted to analyze. So the neuroscientists, cognitive scientists, AI scientists, they all came together. As a matter of fact, AI, one of the components is language learning. My point again here is, friends, if you want to use internet of this thing, everything, you will have to think, understand and educate first. Today, some 8,000 or some 8 billion or 10 billion or 15 billion devices are connected to IoT. The projection is 50 billion. Again, about those 15 billion, 99% of them are in America or developed world, not in India. What great scope you have. What 50 billion we talk, probably they are talking about India. India is a market. Come here. Then opportunities for you. You will have to think about it. You'll have to see that what solutions can be given, and you'll have to see that what social habits, psychology, mindset of Indians, and accordingly you have to provide solutions through IoT. So personally, I feel India, we have a great opportunity. And what we lack only, I think we are on the same wavelength. I can show you some email I had sent to all my heads about communication and data capturing and converting that into a product. Now this seminar today is a great knowledge enhancing process. Hardly 100 boys are listening to that. There are about 800 students in Polytechnic and 17,000 students in our campus. Now because of internet technology, we can deliver this, everything what is happening today, all speeches of these two and all throughout the day what they are going to happen, to those students through your internet. And that's what I want, this proceedings, they're all been videotaped, convert them into product, splice them into title-wise this thing, and within 2-3 days they should be available on your internet. Then you can see them, I don't think you can, both the speeches, I will have to go and listen to them twice or thrice again. Listen to them. There are lots of inputs for you, for future technocrats. You can take lots of clues from them, but you'll have to listen to that again. That's a data. We'll have to process that data and make it available to you on any device again. So my appeal to your heads here and faculties and of course to students, that in this campus itself we are generating massive data. There are guest lectures, there are seminars, there are other activities happening from cultural to other things. What is happening to that? It's all going west. That should not happen. There's a lot of human energy, cost, physical cost, economic cost, time consumed. It should be available as a knowledge base. And that's what from the educational institute point of view, I personally feel that let's convert all these things into such things that they are available to you. Any time, anywhere you want, it will be available to you. Second thing I would request you, sir, yes, there is a lot of possibility of starting new courses. Now, I don't want again this to be only a ritual to have. You must start within 2-3 months, take some clues from this. Dr. Joshi is there, Dr. Chitra is there, Lima is there, and many other people, those are going to speak, they can be of help to you. But some course we must be able to offer, new course. Now, students, you are too slow. I know that, you can correct me. We had started embedded system course couple of months back or years back. When I asked him, he said he had to stop that course because students were not enrolling. Now imagine that 5 years back we had started that course. Now embedded system is a part of this IoT. You have to embed everywhere, everything in all those objects what you are talking, ultimately IP address or whatever you want to communicate to your own language of this thing has to be there in that object, embedded in that. And that's a science, that's a new branch. Similarly, I would ask Dr. Joshi, which we have already discussed, data analytics. You're not going to be, this, every branch of knowledge, be it commerce, arts, science, management, everywhere, without data analytics, you are not going to survive now. If you want to do anything, you must learn those techniques. So these are the possible courses which can come out of this seminar. And I would request students. I don't know why it's so small. You have 800. And there are hardly 80 students here. Why I'm telling you this, why are you not feeling and your friends are not feeling they're losing something? You have heard them. This is going to be the whole day you are going to be this thing. This is a ready-made delivery given to you. You don't have to read. It's a online. Listen to them carefully what they are going to speak. Enough. It's equal to about reading 2 books on IoT. Why are we not taking advantage of that? I don't know. I don't understand why. I know the answer. We, the Indians, are too slow in all this. We are good at preaching. We are good at talking. We are good at discussing. We are good at saying what Modi did wrong, politicizing everything. Well, friends, we are not going to survive with that. Internet technology developed 30 years back, 20, 25 years back, not again in India. That was for defense purpose. Remember, that was for American defense, not for anything, not for your toys or not for your other things. Then what about our own defense? Don't we require anything? We require many things. Technology we require. And it's not going to stop. The worst part or a good part of it, it's not going to stop whether you like it or not, whether you take it or whether you are interested in it or not. Take advantage. Take advantage of such situation, take advantage of such events, and see, we are talking about startups. And this is an extremely good base for startups. You can come together, two or three of you, you can think about it, you can consult them and think of starting some startup. So huge potentialities are here. The faculty should also think, they should guide their students. And last but not the least, I can tell you, we are going to obviously going to give you more opportunities. The Tata Consultancy Services, we are going to enter with the MOU. 750 courses will be available to you in this campus. They are online from 15 days to 3 months to maybe 6 months at a very nominal charge. That is why we are doing that. That's through IoT. It's going to be possible on online. And company like Tata Consultancy is coming to us. We are entering into MOU. Please take advantage of those facilities to you. Where you are getting polytechnic diploma, along with that you must get 4, 5, 6, depending upon your liking and your interest, such courses through. Well, friends, again, I would congratulate Dr. Naik and his team for such a wonderful subject they are going to discuss. Make them available on net as early as possible. And I request all students to take advantage of this. And with these few words, I thank you all. Thank you.